Hello, welcome to the first annual Nexus Report. My name is Callum Sanders, and I will be your host for this year's webcast. We have a lot of exciting announcements this year, but before we take a look at some of our new projects we will be working on this year, let's take a look at our Philippines-based animation studio, Couscous Studio. Join me on this journey as we meet Couscous. Network Nexus are proud to present Couscous Studios. Based in the Philippines, this intrepid team of artists have come together from various walks of life to work on what they love most, animation. They work in collaboration with our new graphics design company, Network Nexus Design. Come and join us as we take a brief look into how an idea is grown and developed by Couscous and what leads them to create their whimsical works. Our guide for this tour is the leader of the Couscous team, Carl Valencia. Let's dive right in.
Hi guys. Ako si Carl Valencia and I am the CEO of Couscous Studio. So, katulad sa una, nag-plan mismo mga amigo na mag-imog studio. That was way back 2019. Dugi-dugi na punto siya. And then medyo ambitious kayo kay dako kay siya na kuan pangarap. So nag-establish mig Couscous ato, but then nabuts pandemic. So alisod kay i-target og kuan karon source of income, and ang uban namo ka kauban kay tuwa sa Australia and Manila, and ako kay naa ko Cebu. So planning put a company here sa Cebu Pudpohon. But then, pandemic, and here we are right now working and saving all our money, investing soon enough na ma-establish ni siya.
This worldwide pandemic has seen many businesses come to a grinding halt. But the creativity and adaptability of Carl and his team lets them work on various requests and projects from across the globe in the safety of their own homes. With both teamwork and tenacity, they've successfully completed several unique projects, such as their Death by Chili venture.
So, ang katong Death by Chili kay very ambitious ra kay ito sa mua, and I don't know if ma-pull off ba jud namo. I know daghan kami atong mga mistakes and daghan po kami mga things na wa po namo na consider, and one of them kay rotoscoping. So gigimiginan sa rotoscoping ato, and then ang amuang aim jud ato, my vision for that is ang Death by Chili will be the first ad campaign naghimo as anime sa Cebu.
So, how do Carl and his team do it?
So, how did we do it? Nag-ask ang client sa mua na saon ninyo. So, yan ako na let's do anime. Nasya kang client kay ganahan kay siya sa idea. I just found out na fan po siya mga anime and Ghibli. Nag-imo mi storyboard, gipasa na ko sa Yaha, and then giganahan siya sa results sa storyboard, and then gi-divide na mo as a team, and sometimes we eat real food and sliced and chopped onions and garlic and chilies para lang jud ma-achieve na mo. And then at the end, napo ko'y background sa graphic design. So gi-collect pud nako tanan at the end ako iga check ana tanan sa quality, and then there we go. Death by Chili.
Interesting. And Carl, do you have any final remarks?
Okay, last words. I'm training students here in Cebu for free, online class. 46 interns and more are willing to join and listen to how the process in Couscous Studio works, and hopefully anime industry in Philippines, specifically Cebu, will rise up. And hopefully these young ones will be the one to do animations in the next few years.
And now, on to some upcoming projects from Network Nexus Studios. Do you want to make friends with kobolds? Then you're in luck. Join Kennedy Phillips as he introduces his new audio drama, Clutch, A Kobold Story. This is a project that will be produced by Network Nexus Studios in collaboration with Melody Gun Studios.
Powerful, monstrous reptiles that breathed fire and ruled the land with an iron stomach. They were the dragons. And underneath them were loyal clans that served them for generations. Through thick and thin, hot and cold, they were called kobolds. There was me, Strap the Trapmaker.
Me, Book the Booker.
And there was Nom, the Helfer. Nom!
Did you do the long ago bit yet?
Yeah, we did.
Because I like that bit. Can we do it again?
We already did.
Long ago, there was Cardboard.
Nom, come on!
And there was me.
What happened to your doodle, Nom?
I got hungry.
What do we do?
Oh, hang on. Ah! Someone bit off my face!
Greetings. Hang on. Greetings. My name is Kennedy Phillips. I'm what you would call a sound designer. A sound designer is basically just a fancy word for someone who bangs pots together for money. You may actually know some of my work from projects like There's also
unknown vessel still closing astern.
Clear for action.
Get away from those, you sheep!
Oh, a thousand
times! You get the idea. You know, I love sound design. It's the perfect way to tell a story without having any visual talent whatsoever. And trust me, I have no visual talent whatsoever. But if there is one thing I know I do have, is noise talent. It's a lot better than it sounds. For those of you who aren't familiar, an audio drama is a form of audio-only entertainment that used to be played on the radio, before television invented YouTube.
One you might know of is a radio play of The War of the Worlds by Orson Welles.
This world was being watched closely by intelligences greater than man.
Right now, I'm looking to do a new show entirely, on a much smaller scale. It's called Clutch, A Kobold Story.
But you're not hurt.
If I drink more when I'm not hurt, I'll never get hurt.
Has that ever worked?
I like the taste.
In Clutch, it takes place in the same universe as my other show, Magus Elgar, but many, many years in the past, during the Age of Dragons.
Kobolds are frantic little creatures, about 3 feet tall, who worship dragons. They're silly, not very smart, and have very short attention spans. There are heroes in this tale. In the deep recesses of the dormant volcano of Mount Krakum resides a great dragon, the benevolent Gouginvor the Crimson. His kobold servants, the clan Fine, You're a Clan Now, Let Me Sleep, or Clan Fine for short, answer to his every beck and call and test his every nerve. At least they did, until Gouginvor developed a tragic case of the not-alives. Contagious, I'm told. So it's up to three kobolds to find a new master before the dreaded dragon slayer Krillia Spine Shatter comes to destroy Clan Fine. There's Book the Booker, resident scribe and literally the only one that knows how to read.
You got some time to spare? I can tell you about my favorite fonts.
Maybe later. Nom, the resident healer, who really only knows how to drink healing potions.
If I just keep drinking these healy potions, I'll be immortal. I won't die!
And the leader of the expedition, the clever trap maker, Strap.
I'm the one that kills the master!
Well, that's just great, Strap, but you probably shouldn't be proud of that.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
We'll be making a audio drama about 6 episodes in length. That's about 30 to 35 minutes per episode. We'll have full voice acting, sound design, composing, Foley, all recorded at Scenic Melody Gun Studios in Hollywood, California, with the assistance of the wonderful people over at Network Nexus. I want to thank you all for being such amazing backers. As of recording this, we are expected to hit our goal of $18,000. I'm just genuinely floored by how much support we've gotten in such short time. But don't think we're done just because we hit our goal. There's still lots of slots left, and the more people we get supporting the show, the easier it is for us to afford the physical rewards and dedicate more of it to us paying our team and getting you more content. We have a series of stretch goals set up that we can offer if you decide you want to support us even more. First up, our initial stretch goal will be a very short expansion of the project. We have a few short, around 8-minute skits that we can do with our kobolds that's sure to be as funny as the rest of the series. Little segments about Strap, Nom, and Book traveling between the episodes. Once we've hit 30,000, we'll also be able to open up a full pin set of each of the kobolds and Gouginvor himself. So if you want to get a full set of pins, be sure to stick around when we actually get to that 30,000 stretch goal. Going beyond that, we have ideas for 2 more full episodes in the wings we can offer if you kobold friends want to see this go from a mini-series to a full-on season. That would make Clutch a Kobold Story 10 episodes long. Once we hit 60,000, we'll be able to finance the whole series independently and even set up prototypes for a custom-made plushie of Strap the Trapper for later available purchase. Finally, if you liked the initial opening to our Kickstarter video, if we can reach a ridiculous $100,000, we'll be able to make an entire pilot for Clutch a Kobold Story as an animated series, made by the same team who did our opening, who've worked on projects like Farfetch'd, Has-Been Hotel, and Hell of a Boss. But like all animation, its cost would be a lot more expensive than our entire audio drama's budget. So please continue supporting us. We've still got a ways to go and so much to offer if the series manages to hit their stretch goals. We really want to thank you for taking the time to listen to our proposal, and we really hope that you decide to back us. With your help, we'll be able to give the kobolds an adventure of their own. Until then, this is Kennedy Phillips, thanking you for watching this video.
The 2021 Nexus Report is brought to you by First Institute. First Institute is a digital media school based in Orlando, Florida, offering educational programs in recording arts, film and video production, and web and graphic design. Their approach to education includes hands-on learning, small class sizes, and industry-standard projects, all for affordable tuition. They are inviting everyone to come and tour their brand new campus that just opened in Orlando, with large recording studios, production labs, and sound stages where media magic comes to life. With an instructional staff of Grammy-nominated music producers, filmmakers, and award-winning graphic designers, First Institute is a hub of opportunities for students and creatives alike. Become a part of the growing First Alumni group that has gone on to shape the entertainment industry around the United States and across the globe. For more information, go to first.edu. Get ready for a knockout. Join Quinn Allen as he discusses our pilot game, Ready, Steady, Rumble, and the new changes we will be making to our indie game development studio, Cosmic Latte Studio.
Hello and welcome to the new and improved Cosmic Latte Studio. This is your game director and lead animator, Quinn Allen, here to let you know about our upcoming title, Ready, Steady, Rumble. You may have noticed our brand has undergone a significant change. We believe our new logo helps represent the depths of our creativity much better than our previous one. Our first title, Ready, Steady, Rumble, is currently in development. After the paramilitary group Maelstrom kidnaps a defenseless 15-year-old girl, a group of unlikely heroes give chase to stop the organization, rescue the girl, and save the world. Classic beat-em-ups meet shmup gameplay in a stylized action-adventure romp through the streets of Luso City and beyond. We plan on having a wide variety of characters and environments to enjoy. Let's take a look at our colorful cast of characters.
Guy loves to fight and has developed a well-rounded style with a focus on devastating punches. His biggest aspiration in life is striving to become stronger and pushing himself to become the best fighter in Luso City. Don't let his brash, cocky exterior fool you. Our main character is known for his good heart. Guy and Alex are lifelong friends. Hard not to be when you meet such a bright, bubbly girl with a sporting attitude about everything. Where he focuses on knockouts, Alex is agile and can kick your butt to the next town over. Resident Grease Monkey and best friend of Guy, Marco is tough, gruff, and stoic to the bone. Fiercely loyal to his friends, he will help them out of any bind. Hope this grappler doesn't get you within final blow distance, or you're totally out of commission. Nazu abandoned her home village and her rightful position as leader of the ninja, and now strives to better the world from behind the scenes. Her masterful combat background, along with embracing modern weapons and fighting styles, combine to create a unique blend of dynamic martial arts. Environmentalist Keon fights for nature and modern civilization to live in harmony. It might look like he's just wielding a wooden practice sword, but his druid-like abilities make his melee attacks a force to be reckoned with. A genetic experiment who narrowly escaped from the lab where he was created, Bob's memory of his past is spotty at best. Dorky and inviting, with a penchant for pop culture, he gets a kick out of showing off his body's unique manipulation abilities and transforming various parts of himself into the perfect weapon.
The game features a fun build-your-own combo system full of flashy special moves and devastating supers, which we will detail at a later date. The gameplay is split between several zones, with each zone containing exciting enemies and challenges, as well as colorful, varied bosses to encounter. Each character has their own unique interactions and backgrounds to uncover. We're still early in development, and we have a lot of surprises in store. We look forward to sharing more information in the future as it becomes available. If you want to keep up on the latest character designs, boss unveilings, and more, be sure to follow us on Twitter and check out our weekly Wednesday live stream on Twitch. Links on the screen and in the description below.
Network Nexus Studios wants to take this opportunity to highlight great animation and underrepresented animators. Here are a few indie artists whose talent is being featured in this year's Indie Animation Spotlight.
Yo.
This concludes the 2021 Nexus Report. You can support the Kickstarter campaigns for any of the projects mentioned in this report in the links down below. I have been your host, Callum Sanders, and I look forward to seeing you next year.